Hey, what's up, ladies and gentlemen? I'm Inyo Zalea from ToleratedCinematics.com, and today it's Filmmaking Friday, which means that we're going to talk about something filmmaking related. Today we're going to take a look on how to create those animated letterboxes that you see popping up in different kind of YouTube videos. Actually a really popular way on actually letting the audience know that there is a cinematic sequence coming up. So maybe you're talking to the camera and then you see these bars closing in, and then the next frame will be a cinematic sequence. So yeah, that's a really fun technique. I'm going to show you how to create them, how to animate them on, and also how to smooth out the animation, because yeah, that really helps to sell the effect and make it a little bit more professional. Alright, so let's jump into Adobe Premiere Pro and get started. Alright, here we are in Adobe Premiere Pro, and we're going to take a look on how to create those letterbox bars around your video. So we're going to animate them in very smoothly also. So you have these bars before when you're talking in a vlog, and then they close in, and then the next shot is going to be a cinematic sequence. It's a really cool way, as I said, to bring your audience to attention that there is a cinematic sequence coming on. So it's actually really simple to do. The first thing that you do is just open your sequence with your cinematic sequence, and as you can see right here, I'm just doing the vlog, and then the rest is cinematic sequence starting from here. So as you can see, I already kind of positioned my frame in shot to be previewed as these black bars come in, but you can still do that later on, so that's not a problem. But this is my cinematic sequence, and then right here we go out of the cinematic sequence and we have a vlog with some audio. Alright, so I want to animate them in and out. So the first thing that I like to do, and this is just my technique on doing it. A lot of people will probably have different kind of techniques, but this is my take on it, and I find it very easy. So what I like to do is go to sequence and add a color map. And then I click OK. And I'll make it completely black and click OK again. So now I have a color mat, I'm going to call this letterbox and click OK, and then just drag it into my sequence right here. So I will drag it on the top layer right here, and then just extend it all the way until my video ends right here. Alright, so now I have just a black solid on top of my video, which is not really what we want, but now we need to mask it out. So what we'll do is go to the effects controls right here, and you will see an opacity tab right here. I'll click right here on the create 4-point polygon mask. If you click on that, you will see something like this going on. The first thing that I like to do is change my mask feather to 0 instead of 10. And then just select these two points, bring them all the way to the left, and select these two points and bring them all the way to the right. Right now, this ladder box has been created in the center of our scene, so now we can really simply extend it by using the mask expansion right here, and that's a really way, a cool way to animate it in and out. But of course, the black bar should be on top and bottom, not in the center, so what we'll do is just invert our mask, and there we go, we have some ladder boxes. The actual size to have as a height when you're doing a cinematic sequence, the best way to go for it, in my opinion, is 800 pixels instead of 1080. So what I like to do is go to the sequence and go to sequence settings and just change the horizontal pixels to 800 and click OK. And then I just like to click OK again. And then what I like to do is play with the expansion until we actually touch, and I'm doing this with the shift and arrow up key, by the way, and try to touch the edges, kind of plus minus, and there we go. So now we have a perfect cinematic sequence. Maybe 260 will be perfect, or actually 255, let's say, or 265, okay. So now we have the perfect kind of size of our 800 pixels, and I will go back to sequence settings and just change this back to 1080 and click okay, okay, and there we go. So now we have these black bars in there, and we should have the exact size of a cinematic kind of aspect ratio. Of course, you can go a little bit lower and just lower this until something extremely widescreen. It's completely up to you. This could also look very cool. So it's completely up to you. You can just modify it, but the original kind of size is 265, well, 800 pixels right here. I like to do it a little bit more as personal preference. I like this kind of widescreen style. So what I'll do is just keep it as it is right here. And then what I want to do is just find that key where I want it to be completely in here. So right here we have a vlog, and then right here I want it like almost at the start. And if we zoom in a little bit, almost at the start of our cinematic sequence, I'm going to click on a keyframe for our letterbox. So make sure that your letterbox layer has been selected and click on the stopwatch for mask expansion right here. Go a few frames back, maybe right here, and then click for another keyframe. If we zoom in here in our effects control timeline, we will see that we now have two keyframes, and we can actually make sure that this is increased until we don't see our mask anymore in our screen. So I think this is about right. And now we have our letterbox animating in just like this. Right now we have a quite very linear kind of animation. Maybe you want to extend it a little bit more so it's a little bit slower in animation. But we have something like this, and it's not as smooth as it could be. So what I like to do is just select my both keyframes, right click, and go for a bezier. And now it's a little bit smoother, but we can still smooth it out a little bit more by just opening the arrow right here and just extend these knots right here. So if we unselect everything, select this one, and maybe extend it out just a little bit, not too much. And the same goes for this one, extend it out a little bit like this. Now we should have a very smooth animation. So let's preview this. Okay, and maybe at the end you want to slow it down even more, because the end is actually the most important, and at the beginning we can actually speed it up just a little bit, and that's going to come to a very slow and nice cinematic stop. So that's really going to fit the cinematic sequence, especially if you're working with slow motion. Everything that is subtle and comes in smoothly just works out of the batch. So right here we have a nice letterbox coming in, and we have the rest of our scene. As we extended this layer all the way on our video, we will see that now the letterbox is all the way across our video. And then right here, before we enter in another vlog section, we can actually create a new keyframe and then just move it a few frames. So let's say we do it like eyeball it a little bit right over here, and we can just increase it until we don't see it anymore, or just copy the first keyframe right here, but actually just do it like this. Okay, there we go. And now it's animating out, and we have our vlog going on. So that's really cool. By the way, the audio that I used for this cinematic sequence is actually from Levito Beats. He's a good friend of mine. He has a channel all about beats, and he uploads beats that you can use for free in your YouTube videos. So go and check him out, give him some love with the link in the description. And apart from that, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you did, give this video a like. Also subscribe to the channel for more, and definitely check out our website. We have a bunch to offer for filmmakers, motion graphics artists, and if you buy something, it helps to support the channel. Hope to see you in the next one, and goodbye.